creative friends, it's Gwen and I am back with another scrapbooking process video. Today's share is for Coco Vanilla Studio and I am using their Divine Daydream collection. I've got lots of bits and pieces. I have made several layouts with this collection, so here's what I have left. Now I'm also scrapbooking a photograph of myself. I'm on a bit of a mission to get a couple more photos of me on my pages. And I'm using this cut file. This one is from Cut to You and it is called Love Your Selfie. So yeah, I am very much on a mission to get a couple more photographs of myself onto my layouts in 2021. So hopefully all plans going well, you will be seeing a few more like this layout. And I've got a bit of a plan. I am going to use the cut file as a bit of a foundation for my design, and it's going to be very centered. And then, I'm just going to add my photo above it somewhere there and then get to the fun stuff. So to create the background of my layout there, I have used the pattern paper Garden Variety, and I've actually used two sheets of it. One I had, see that floral that's around the edge of the layout? That is actually, I think, the A side, and then the grey is the B side. So I did end up using two sheets of this pattern paper, but I did save the inner part that I had cut from the border there because it's too pretty not to save up. To back the cut file, I have used the watercolor stripe. That one is called Stepping Stones. I've also used, see that really pretty kind of abstract watercolor pattern? That one is called Sweet Serenity, and the florals in it, you will see that's from the inside of that garden variety paper. So yeah, some of the insides I have used in the cut file there, and I've got a stack left over for another layout. Oh yes, and I have used the pattern paper called All a Flutter. Now that one is the one with all the butterflies on the front that you can fussy cut. But on the B side, it has the most divine peachy apricot background with these sweet little pale hearts printed on it. And that's the pattern paper that I've used to back the word selfie. So you can see that there. So lots of different pattern papers from the collection that I've mixed and matched to make my page. So now that I have the larger elements of my page locked into their position and I have a real plan for this design, I do get to do my favorite part, which is adding all of the embellishments. So I have gone ahead and fussy cut out a stack of those florals from the pattern paper. I actually did that very early on when I first got the collection. I actually put on some Netflix, grabbed out my fussy cutting scissors and cut out a whole sheet except for the border, because I knew that I would use that on a page like this one. Cut out all of the floral pieces that I could from that pattern paper. And it's just really great to have them there ready to go. And then I can add them and mix and match them in to all of my paper layers and my embellishment clusters whenever I feel like it. Now for my embellishment clusters, what I thought I might do is add a larger one to the bottom section of the page there where I'm working, and that's going to really ground the page. But then to balance that out, I'm going to be adding another embellishment cluster to the top right hand corner of my photo. Now what that's going to do too is help draw the eye down and around the page. So hopefully it starts at my photo top right hand corner, it travels down past my title and then to the left to the bottom embellishment cluster. Now to make those, I'm actually just mixing and matching a stack of goodies from the collection. So I have my fussy cut florals that I mentioned just before. I also have quite a few elements from the die cut ephemera pack, and I've also got some other elements that I fussy cut out, including those little rainbows. So they have been cut from the cut apart sheet and I will be using those, and later you'll see in the little stash at the top Right. there's those moths. Those moths have also been fussy cut from one of the pattern papers. So I'll be using all of those. I'm also going to be adding the corduroy heart. So it's like a puffy heart that comes in a, I think it's a pack of six in three different colors, and they are really, really sweet. They have this slight shimmer to them. So it's a real slight, shine and shimmer to them, and they're really lovely. Okay, so I did just quickly go and double check, and the puffy hearts come in a pack of eight. So yeah, they're really, really pretty, really pretty. And also the moths that I've cut are from the All the Flutter paper, which is the A side of that lovely peachy apricot in the selfie word there. So it's the other side of that pattern paper. And the cut apart sheet that the rainbows have come from, that one is called Happy Place. So now you know all the bits and pieces. Just get the whole collection, really. You need it all, trust me. Now I'm also going to be using the accessory sticker sheet, and as you got a little look there's a bunch of really sweet elements at the top of the sheet, and then down the bottom there is a stack of typed sentiments, and I really love these. I use these all the time, and I'm going with, for this layout, I'm going with three, and they say be happy, keep smiling, and live your best life. So I'm just going to stagger them near my title there. I've also got, which I thought I saw before. Yeah, there, I've used, I'm going to use one of the flare buttons from the collection as well. And it says The Good Life, and it does end up on my page. I love the dimension of them. I love that they're a bit of a different texture. So we have the, you know, the lovely paper layers, and then we have a fabric element with the puffy heart, and then a nice shiny flare button and some dimension. So I love the look of that. I am also adding a little bit of foam tape behind some of the die cut pieces just to add a little bit of dimension. So this collection doesn't have chipboard as such, but for that same kind of look, all you need to do is add a little bit of foam under some of the pieces, and then you get those really nice paper layers and that added dimension for your page. Now, to build my embellishment clusters, I actually like to start with the larger piece of the cluster first. So in this case, it was those florals. And then I like to add on top of those some elements that are maybe medium sized. So in the bottom cluster there, it would be that pink flower. In the top cluster, it's that little tab with the rainbow on it. And then maybe even this flower here that I'm like, oh, is that medium sized? And once the medium sized embellishments are locked in and everything's looking good, I then add my smallest embellishment. So it might be a little leaf element, it might be an enamel dot, something sparkly, some sequins or something like that. And that's how I get the layers in my clusters and all of that interest in the design of them. Now, if you've watched any of my videos at all, you will know that I do like to audition things. So I can't actually remember why, but for some reason I had decided to change up that floral cluster in the top right-hand corner. And that's exactly why I don't glue anything down until the page is almost complete. So I like to have all of my elements positioned and be 200% sure that I'm happy with everything before I start gluing things down. Quite often though, I do go back to what I originally had, so I should learn just to stick with it. But I just, the way that I create, I really like to audition all of the things in all of the places. And then, once everything's locked into position, that's when I'll go back and do my gluing, which you will see here in a moment. Yeah, so it is, things are getting serious. There is a little bit of adhesive going on to die cuts and things. You'll also notice that I try not to lift up the elements while I'm gluing. So I like to just move the page around like so, and then add a little bit of glue underneath the elements without moving them. And that's because I've taken so much time to position them, and I'm really particular about where they are. often I would find that if I lifted the element up to add the glue, when I went to stick it back down, I couldn't get it back into the same position. So yeah, I've just found that that's easiest for me. And yeah, I just work my way around the page, adding my adhesive as I go. And I do like to glue down everything. The glues are really good on the cocoa vanilla stuff, but I am living in a really high humid heat area, and it's really just me being probably over concerned about not wanting to have to re-glue everything. So yeah, I just add a little bit of liquid glue pretty much to everything on all my layouts forever and ever. I'm just going to be adding 3 of the moths to the page. I'm using some foam tape for those, and they will finish out the layout. I will leave you with some close-up still images here in a moment. I hope you enjoyed this layout. If you like the way that I scrapbook or the way that I chat about the way that I scrapbook, be sure to give me a thumbs up or subscribe so that you can keep seeing my latest videos. I've got so much planned for 2021. Thank you so much for being here, my creative friends, and I will see you next time. Bye!